In this video, we're going to use the normal distributions and central limit theorem tool in Google Sheets, and we're going to use the inverse calculation section to answer problems. So let's get started. Okay, so in the normal distribution central limit theorem tool we have up here, we're going to use this tool to answer these questions on the right. And for this first problem, on a planet far from away from Earth, IQ of the ruling species is normally distributed with a mean of 103 and a standard deviation of 16. Suppose that one individual is randomly selected or chosen. Let X equals the IQ of an individual. So that's how we're defining our random variable X. And as you can see, we have X in here. But anyways, and a school offers special services for all children in the bottom 5% for IQ scores. So we're looking at the bottom 5%. What is the highest IQ score a child can have and still receive special services? So we want to find the highest value at the 5%. Or in other words, we're going to find the fifth percentile. So the fifth percentile would be located, if we're thinking of which tool to use, we wouldn't want the probability calculations. The probability calculations is used to find a probability from a value in the normal distribution. But in this case, we want to find the normal distribution value from a probability, the probability being 5%. So we're going the opposite direction. We're starting with the probability, and we want to find the value. So that's why this is called inverse calculations. We're going the opposite direction. So we're inputting, remember, we're entering data in the green cells only. So we're entering in the probability, and we're going to find the value. Now, which tool do you want to use out of these three? Well, it depends on what's being asked. It says the bottom 5%. So the area to the left is 5%. So we're going to use this tool right here. Area to the left is shaded, and we're going to put in 0.05. Enter that in. But we also first want to enter in the mean. We don't have the mean and standard deviation yet. So we would enter in the mean of 103 and standard deviation of 16. 103, 16. And we have a value of 76.68 and so forth. So interesting. So we know that 76 would be at the fifth percentile. So 5% of values would be below 76. It kind of makes sense since we have a mean of 103 and a standard deviation of 16. The center of the distribution is at 103, which is the 50th percentile. So the fifth percentile, which is to the left over here, would be at 76, so below that mean. All right, so that is the first value. And keep in mind, according to the instructions, we want to round all your answers to two decimal places. So that would be 76.68. All right, now we want to find the interquartile range. Well, actually, in this case, we just want to find Q1 and Q3. I cut off the last part. We don't actually care about the IQR. You can find that on your own. So Q1 and Q3. So Q1 is defined as the 25th percentile. And that would be 0.25. So the 25th percentile will be located at 92. Now Q3, and remember to round to two decimals, 92.21, Q3 would be the 75th percentile. So we'd put 0.75, and there we go. Round to two decimals, we're good. All right, and then you would then next be asked for IQR if you had this problem. But we're not interested in that right now. Okay, for the next problem, we are looking at the length of pregnancies in a small rural village. It's normally distributed with a mean of 269 days and a standard deviation of 16 days. Okay, so we're gonna change the mean to 269. Standard deviation is still 16, okay. In what range would you expect to find the middle 90% of most pregnancies? Okay, now that middle represents the third chart. And notice again, we're starting out with a probability here, a probability of 98%, and we're trying to find the values. So again, we're going the inverse direction. Probability, again, goes from a value to a probability. But we're going from a probability to values. So we're going the inverse direction. So we're using inverse calculations. Okay, so we will enter in the green, the probability of 0.98. And this part of the tool automatically makes it the middle area. So that it's perfect for this sort of problem. So middle. And notice that the tool up here for probability calculations, it's not in the middle. That's because this tool allows you to choose whatever x1 and x2 values. This only works for the middle area. So a little limitation there, but you probably won't see any problem. Most problems are usually created, so you're looking at the middle if you're using inverse calculations and dealing with between. So those are the two values, 231.78 and 306.22, has 98% of the values between with this mean and this standard deviation with a normal distribution. All right, so that is how you use the inverse calculations tool. I did not go over this middle one here, but this involves problems where you have above some, has some area above. So we didn't see a problem like that, but it's very similar to below problems. Anyways.